Hi, I'm Katinka.
And I'm Thomas.
Today we'll take you on a tour with us.
Around the labs and Raman spectroscopy too.
We'll show you exactly what it is we do.
Bert Weckhuis's group is all about catalysis.
Synthesis, characterization and analysis.
Spectroscopy is what we're interested in.
From UV vis and IR to electron spin.
In Raman spectroscopy, a molecule is excited to a virtual state.
But due to its inelastic nature, the amount of scattering isn't great.
That's why SERS is the focus of our topic.
With gold particles that are really microscopic.
They exhibit surface plasmon resonance due to their size.
Which are collective surface electron oscillations that can maximize
both incoming and outgoing radiation.
Enabling the detection of a single molecule's vibration.
We want to apply this concept to catalysis.
Unfortunately, there are some issues with this.
Photocatalytic reactions are no problem at all.
Like reduction of DMAP to amino thiophenol.
SERS allows the study of such reactions.
And to look in detail at the interactions.
However, for studying catalysis not induced by light,
the size of 60 nanometer particles just isn't right.
But make them smaller and you'll see.
The plasma resonance disappears consequently.
So if we want to study a catalyst more real,
then maybe the application of SHINERS is a good deal.
It stands for Shell Isolated Nanoparticle-Enhanced Raman Spectroscopy.
And it's easily integrated with microscopy.
The technique is based on particles of gold.
With a coating of oxide that serves threefold.
First of all, the stability is increased.
Up to 500 centigrades at least.
Next to that, the oxide helps prevent
the occurrence of side reactions we can now circumvent.
Use the shins as simple gold at SiO2.
And there's already plenty you can do.
Mix them with actual catalysts on the substrate.
Gain in situ info on formed carbonate.
Still one more, well, subsequently,
you get to purpose number 3.
Our last option for the shell
is to function as support as well.
Deposit on your shin any actual cat.
Make anything you wish you had.
According to us, this is the way
that makes SHINERS here to stay. Though there's one technique we have not yet addressed.
Look at our title and you might have guessed.
It's the integration of AFM and SERS.
Which is commonly known as TERS.
And with a metal substrate combined.
As gap mode TERS it is defined.
In both techniques, a tiny tip is employed.
And higher resolution can be enjoyed.
Since you only measure around the tip's apex,
the technique becomes a bit more complex.
This, however, results in single molecule resolution,
even enabling intermediate attribution.
This will help with catalytic pathway elucidation.
So using TERS is a recommendation.
Make sure the tips have high stability.
Coat them like shins, but with Al2O3.
Let us just end by saying this.
SHINERS and TERS have a bright future in catalysis.
Want to understand enhanced Raman spectroscopy and catalysis better? Check out our JVis Chem Perspective letter.